Hey, it's not like I'm trying to blame anybody for anything, but I just want to let y'all know where we are coming from. I'm gonna look forward instead of at the camera because yeah. So when we were young, Gabriel put us against each other. He made us take turns. After a while, my brother realized that he was older, and he decided to stop. But I was younger. And so Gabriel didn't stop turns on me. There was a point. Whoa. Before the point, we would always have fun. We would always, we had a pool in the backyard, and our families would come over, and it was like the whole religious whole thing. I remember it being like a whole everybody come over from church. And we had this space in the corridor from the laundry room to the backyard. And that is where you will catch me. Because after a while, my brother was like, no, but I was obviously 2 years younger than him, so I was only six. I don't know what was going on. I remember having bunk beds and him telling me that this milk coming out was a reward for me because I did something good. I also remember being in the pool with another one. You know who he is. And I remember him Oh my God, it hurts to say it. I remember him taking me in and making me feel special and making me feel like as long as I didn't say anything, then I was okay. I also remember him pinning my brother against me. I remember sitting in my sister's shrinking room with two tuck beds. And he took turns on us. All I wanted to do was look at my sister and watch how high she got her bangs, because she got her bangs so hot. I remember waiting who is going to help me. But if I said anything, I would be hurting my mom and my dad and my uncles. Because, well, hell, he was my uncle. And then, it was one day, everybody was in the pool. He was halfway inside of me. Dad walked in. And he froze and he did nothing. He sat down on the side and he said, "You won't ever do this again." And I remember him being like, "Okay, I'm the one who's in the wrong." Fast forward an hour or two later, my parents are making us do laundry, and I hear them talking about it. Me and my brother are folding the laundry. And I hear her say, "He's never coming over again." And I'm like, "Mom, you knew. You didn't do anything." And my dad says, "No, it's my nephew. He's never coming over again." And then my brother comes in storming, so mad that his best friend won't come over again. And they say it's my fault. And I'm just like, "It's my fault." At this point, I'm only 8. And I'm just like, "It's my fault?" And then, this whole time, I have been sleeping with my neighbor across the street from 2 to 12th grade. And this whole time, my sister knew. And this whole time, my sister also knew that Gabriel was doing all this to us. And she held that as blackmail against us. So we were like, "Well, if our own sister is not going to protect us." For me, I was like, "My own sister is not going to protect us. My own dad is not going to protect us." I remember being in the van one day. And she was like, if you do not give me this, I'll tell everybody everything. And I was so scared. And so I gave her my butterfinger. At that time, she was obese. And she held everything against us. Not just me, David too, because she knew at the time that David was being abused. She was young. She didn't know what she was doing. And I don't blame her for it. I really don't. She didn't know what she was doing. But as we get older, I hate myself because there was a moment after my first, was my first, my second, no, it was my first, being caught with cocaine. The officer asked me, do you want to report the molestation? And I told him no, because I was afraid of what it would do to my family. I was afraid of what it would do to my aunts. I should have. Because apparently he's still doing it to the point to where he had to move somewhere else. I feel like it's my fault. It hurts so much because I know it's... And so... And then I think about my brother James. And I'm like, I have so much resentment against him because he never treated me like a brother. He was more best friends with my brother, with my friend. Mark, I would come home and I would walk into the room and they would be hanging out and playing PlayStation. They would go fishing together. What was so wrong with me? He didn't want to encourage me or want to do that with me. Instead, he chose a person across the street. A person across the street who we were having sex with, and he didn't want to believe that when I told him. And David went home. And all these emotions are coming back, and I don't know what to do. I feel so lost. I feel so low. If I love somebody, I can't. I remember when I did love somebody. I remember when I loved Brett. We were in the front yard, and we fought. I did spit in his face, and then he came swinging at me, and then James went out, and he took care of Brett. And everybody, my mom, and James believed Brett over me. They believed they didn't know the whole story because my whole thing was, I'm not going to tell my family what is going on. Because I don't want them to tell me you were wrong. Because my whole life, they have told me I was wrong. My whole life, they have told me I was wrong. My whole life, they were saying, why aren't you as smart as David? My whole life, they were saying, why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? I have felt like I'm living like for somebody else. James and Elizabeth were good brothers and sisters. But they did not see everything that was going on. They did not. See everything that was going on. And then what they did, it was like, was our fault. Our parents are so good parents. They did nothing but work hard and support us. But at the end of the day, like, we were alone. And I still feel alone. I still feel alone.